Welcome to another episode of Bite-Sized. My name is June, and I'm here today with my very special guest, KK.
Hi, June. I'm Keerthana Kumar, also go by KK.
KK, why don't you take a minute to introduce yourself?
I am a developer at Microsoft in the Visual Studio Mobile Center team, especially in the crashes team, something we're going to look at today.
Very cool. So what are we looking into crashes specifically today?
So we're going to look at the best practices, how to use crashes to make the life as a mobile developer better so that you can ship great apps.
That's fantastic. And that goes right along the vein of Microsoft and Xamarin's mantra, which is delighting developers. So without further ado, let's get into the best practices of collecting crashes in your mobile app now.
If you see right here, we have an Android app. It is a very simple weather app. Here it has daily page, an hourly page, and a details page. A simple weather app.
That looks fantastic. This really reminds me of Colby's XWeather app. Is this the app that we're using today?
Yep, this is exactly Colby's app.
So for those of you who are interested in the source code on how to build the simple weather app, I'll put a link right down below. For today, what are we getting into?
First thing to use crashes on Mobile Center, we need to integrate it. Since Blanca's already done this before, I'm going to run through this really quickly. Here, if you see in this Bootstrap page, I have integrated the Mobile Center API right here with mobilecenter.start, and I have made sure analytics and crashes has been included.
Great. What KK just talked about in terms of setup, you could go to Blanca's analytics video, which I'll link right down below, and it will show you how to set up your IDE to work with Mobile Center.
Awesome, June. Thank you. Let's start looking at crashes. Before that, let's look at Mobile Center and how you can see the page. So here on Mobile Center, we have the crashes page. I've created an app and I got the app secret from the getting started page. Under crashes, we have no crashes. It says collecting data. So I guess we're waiting for a crash to happen.
Yeah, let's go ahead and crash this app so we could get some awesome data back.
So I'm going to actually detach the emulator from the debugger so we can actually see the crash show up in Mobile Center.
Great.
So if you see here, the XWeather app has stopped working. So I'm going to open the app again. This is when the crash is actually sent.
Awesome. So it looks like Mobile Center registered our crash and it picked it up. And now we have one of these groups down here that shows this crash here, right?
So yeah. So if you can see, we have a few things. We have the analytics show up on the top, usually the crash free users per day and crashes per day. Right now, we just started working on our app, so not much data there. But right down here, we have the groups. So here, what are crash groups? Crash groups are usually crashes that happen in the same file, in the same line. It might be sometimes that it's not exactly the same crash, but we try to optimize for the crash group.
Does it mean that all the similar type of crashes get grouped into one category that you could access?
That's exactly it. And in fact, we create each group per version. So right now we only have one version that you can see on top, 0.81. So we actually categorize each crash group by version so that you can segregate by version.
That's really cool. And that's really good way to kind of manage all these crashes per version and iterate it on the future.
Exactly. Let's dive deeper into the crash group. So if you can see within a crash group, we see on top, we've identified that it's attempted to divide by zero. So that's exactly the crash that I created. And it tells me daily graph view.draw. So this is sort of the symbol or the location where the crash took place. So what I can do as a developer when I see this crash happen, I can go back into my editor, kind of see where I have missed something important to do or I have created a bug. Let's go try to fix this crash. So if you see right here, I have a divider count and I've set that to zero. I obviously shouldn't be setting that to zero, so I'm going to actually set it to 8.
So it looked like the data that you got from Mobile Center helped guide you the exact location on where the error occurred. So then now you can make the remedy to that error and you can redeploy the app again, right?
That's perfect. Now that as a developer, I've kind of fixed the issue, I'm going to go mark on Mobile Center that the rest of people are working on this app, don't go fix it. I've taken care of it. In Mobile Center here, you see that there is an open tag.
So it looks like we have three options here. What does closed and ignored mean?
So usually this is the status of the crash group. Closed technically is used for something that's been fixed. It's a version that's still in the market. There might be crashes that come back. For a sense, in that particular version, we've already fixed the issue, so it's closed. Whereas for ignored, it's something that we don't want to fix. I don't want to see that on my crash list anymore. So for this particular crash group, I'm going to set it to closed.
So it makes working with a team of developers super easy because you could delegate certain tasks to other team members. You could take issues on your own accord and you could close those tasks. And is there a way to see a history of all these closed and ignored tasks?
Yeah, Jun. So let's say I mark this as closed. Now I go back to my crashes and say, hey, no crashes are found in this current filter. Right here on the top, we have versioning, the time of the crash, and the status. So here you can always look at all the closed crashes and the ignored crashes. Now let's go ahead after we've fixed the actual crash, change the version. But before that, I'm going to be adding one more feature that we have on crashes called attachments.
Awesome. What does attachments do?
So attachments are any kind of extra details that you as a developer want to collect at the time of a crash on someone's phone.
Where can I find this little code snippet? I mean, do I need to come up with it on my own or does it live somewhere online?
You can easily find it in the Mobile Center docs right here. This is the C# version of it. This is exactly what I'm using.
So for those of you who don't know where the docs are, I'm going to go ahead and put a link right down below and you can go ahead and access it.
So right here, as you see, I'm adding the similar code snippet that's basically taking sort of a text and putting it in a text file.
Okay, awesome. That seems pretty straightforward enough.
So right now, let's say I've actually sent out the app. There are people using the app. As a developer, you're checking the crashes page.
Definitely. So now we should have a new crash in our new version of the app. I believe it's 8.2, right?
Yeah, 0.8.2. That's exactly what it is. So right here, there's a new crash that came up. It says analytics track page view and crash. So let's go in and look at what it is.
Very cool. So right off the bat, we could see there's awesome stack trace and there looks like there's an object not set to instance of an object.
Interestingly, you can actually click on every single report that you got. So let's say this particular crash has only happened once. So I'm going to click on that and see that, you know, you get a little further information. You see the stack trace. You see attachments right here.
It looks like we could download this attachment as a file and we could just share this with our fellow teammates.
Yeah, actually, they can even look at it from Mobile Center. Or in order for me as a developer to see what the attachment is, I can actually download it and look at it. It says location when crashes. It's exactly what I put. But maybe as a developer, you will have your actual logging on the attachment.
Just to recap, this is a granular set of data from a specific device, right? And this device looks like it's from a simulator. That's why it says x86 on the top. But in a real life scenario, we're going to have a Google Pixel iPhone or we're going to have a S7, right?
Yeah, you can see the list of devices. You can see exactly every single crash report. In fact, you can also see the raw crash. You want to look at the other threads of the crash. This is exactly how you look at it. There's a really cool feature that you can do is annotate a crash.
Is this like a field where you just save notes and you could share with other people on your team?
Basically, whatever you want to type, for instance, if it's a crash that you don't want to fix, you can kind of write a reasoning for why you don't want to fix. Or if it's something that you want to fix later, whatever it is, you can kind of write here. I'm going to say this fix is coming. You see, I wrote a little note for my team here. And on the main crashes page, you can actually see all the annotations that are written for each crash group.
That's super cool. So now we have a very good way of organizing all our crashes. Then we could mitigate it to our fellow teammates. And then we know the status of it, right? We know if it's open or closed or if it's ignored. And then we can make the necessary steps to, you know, get the next version out in a very timely manner.
Exactly. The cool thing is that it, you know, this sort of is like a task board. You can see all your crashes that come up here and you can kind of list of crashes as a task list for your bug tracking.
This looks really cool. And some teams that use other tools like Bugzilla, can you import all this data and annotations into like a Bugzilla or Atlassian or anything like that?
Yeah, this is one of like our top requested feature and we're currently working on it, so keep a lookout for that.
Well, thanks KK for giving us a sneak preview of what's to come in the future, and I really appreciate this in-depth demo on how to utilize crashes in the best practice manner that we preach here at Xamarin and Microsoft.
Thank you so much KK for coming on the show today. I learned a lot about crashes and I know a lot of our viewers out there did as well.
Thanks June for having me. It was a great opportunity for us from the crashes teams to come and show the users how to best use our product.
Great! So for those of you who enjoyed this video, please like the video and subscribe to our channel for any upcoming content. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, I appreciate you.
Peace.